So because we have so much drama already happening in the season, and we're only on episode 4,
yeah.
I feel like it's only appropriate that we have the queen of all the drama. She's always involved in something.
Yeah.
Usually she thinks she knows what's going on. Does she really?
No.
Okay, so let's just bring her out. Holland Roden! Yeah. Come on out! Hi!
Hi. Welcome
to the Well, we were wondering if you would join us for a little slumber party kiki. Are you down?
Shirt dress?
Perfect.
Flannel, perfect.
Let's make it happen. I think we're ready. Let's get down to business.
Yeah.
I got a question.
Yes.
So, with this season, we see a lot more of Lydia's supernatural powers coming about. What are they all about?
That's a good question. That was a question for definitely Jeff Davis, okay. Our amazing showrunner.
So you don't know yet.
We don't even know. I would say that you are going to find out something by the end of the first 12 episodes. I'll give you part A, part B. Somewhere in the duration of Teen Wolf. However, it's still unknown. I can't say too much.
Okay,
I'll get fired.
Okay,
there'll be no more Lydia.
Do you, Holland, have any supernatural intuitions in real life? Can you see dead people?
I'm thinking about this.
Have you ever had an experience when you're like, uh-uh?
I have a really weird thing with luck. On a short term, I have horrible, horrible luck. Like, I am the most, I'm the unluckiest person. It's like, you know, Samuel L. Jackson and Unbreakable, like, times that by 1,000.
That's okay. Oh my goodness.
But at the end of the day, I feel like my entire life is like a Vegas game, because if you cash in all my chips, at the end of the day, I have really big things that happen to me that are amazing. I'm a heavy participant in karma, put it that way. So I definitely think there's some sort of energy pool in the world. I do believe in that.
Yes.
I have to ask, what is going on with Lydia and Stiles?
Please.
Is anything ever going to happen?
What is going on?
There is a really big episode with us coming up. A really big one.
Okay.
It's really big.
You can't just do that to us.
I think the fans are really going to like it.
Okay.
But I mean, throughout the season, we see more and more, I believe it's called Stydia.
Sounds like something you could catch.
Yeah, right?
What are the pros and cons, if you had to choose some, of dating a werewolf?
Yeah.
Pros and cons. Well, she only dated one for such a, you know, minute amount of time.
I still feel like you could see the pros and cons, though.
It's either, like, she's going to end up with another werewolf or, like, an Italian guy because, like, they both have hair. You know what I mean? I feel like, I don't feel like...
Same here.
Like, I feel like Nair has to somewhere be in her future. I love dogs. I'm a dog person in real life. So I would say if you hybrid the two, it's like the KFC bowl. Like, you put all the good stuff in one. You know what I mean?
That is the best
KFC
analogy
bowl for love
I've
lives.
Literally ever heard.
You know? You get, like, a cute guy and you get, like, a dog.
Okay, so this has been so much fun, but I think it's time for a little game called Which Tyler Tweeted. Chantal, would you like to explain the game?
Okay, we're going to read a set of tweets. You have to find out if it's either Tyler Oakley, Tyler Posey, or Tyler Hecklin. Go ahead.
Shaking like a dog, razor blades.
Posey.
No. Next up.
Naked dancers at gay clubs just love when they play One Direction. Want me read it again?
Oh no, I'm getting it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, yeah. Hi.
Well,
duh.
No. We shot it. We went to a lot of gay clubs in Atlanta, actually.
Okay.
Because a lot of we have like a lot of gay guys on our crew.
Happy Halloween, everyone. Have a great time and be safe.
Oh, Hecklin.
Yeah.
Politically correct. Yeah. Love you, Hecklin. That's so Hecklin.
That is Hecklin.
Okay. He's like, Happy Memorial Day. Yeah.
Yes! Go, USA. Congrats to the women's soccer team.
Hecklin.
Yeah. You're good at this. Twitter rampages equal poop time.
Oh, Posey.
Yeah. Yeah, obviously. Yeah.
Pretty solid halftime show by Madonna. Very solid. Yep. Loving the choir.
No,
that was Hecklin. I remember that.
That was a trick question.
Oh, wait, the halftime show.
At the halftime
Damn
show.
Damn it, I thought it was, I heard Madonna.
Connecticut, I am in you.
Posey.
It was me.
You!
Yeah, I was just in Connecticut.
You and Posey have similar humor.
Yeah, we do. It's
because
we're meant to be, basically.
Yeah.
Okay, here's the last one. I'm pretty sure my two favorite seasons are summer and football.
Hecklin.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Hecklin's was about sports in America.
Yeah.
You should run for president.
He just loves America.
Like, that's not ironic.
Okay.
I love Hecklin to death.
We give a shout out this week to hollandstyle.tumblr.com.
Ah. Mm-hmm.
They are amazing because all they ever do is post Holland's best looks and Lydia's best looks, and you can see where she gets them. That's it's amazing.
Very cool.
Yeah, so do you have anything you want to say to them?
Thank you so much. Don't kill me. I think I've seen Tumblr through the like mediums of Instagram and Twitter.
Okay.
Colton Haynes had me go to Tumblr for the first time the other day.
It's a
scary
place.
And I had to
place.
Ask how to spell it.
Oh, that's precious.
And I didn't know how to spell it.
You're new here.
You guys put so much time into this stuff that it's really unreal to me. I don't know how you guys get your homework done, too. Like, it's unreal to me.
Thank you so much for joining us today. This has been so fun.
It's been awesome.
We love this.
Thanks, guys, for inviting me.
Of course. Next time you have to come again, we'll get more pajamas, more snacks, everything.
Perfect.
It'll be great.
Okay. We'll get more.
Thanks, you guys, for watching. Later.
Bye guys. Y'all.